Hello everyone, in today's lecture we will discuss about input and output devices in computer graphics. Just a glimpse of all the concepts. So there are so many input devices in computer graphics such as keyboard, mouse, joysticks, data clock, digitizer, image scanners, touch panel and light panels. Keyboards are used to give inputs like for writing purposes, for creating notepads, and we have so many keyboards like mechanical keyboards, optical keyboards. Clearly we have so many types of mouse to give inputs through clicking, and joystick you usually use to play games, and data glove is something you need to wear in your hand and the inputs are detected through LEDs. Similarly, if we go through, digitizers are a pad created to draw something. It contains a pen, and if someone drew something on that pad, that will be scanned and copied to your system. In these scanners, you use scanners to scan your data. So in scanners, the concept is that the object you are using to scan will be projected through a light, and that reflected light is captured to store that data. Last is touch panels. Touch panels is introduced when ATM is popularized. So to create some input through the screen by touching, we use touch panels. And lastly, the light pens. It has the concept that we directly use it on the CRT monitor, and through the current we supply, it will detect what are the inputs. So in case of computer graphics and in undergraduate course, you just need to know about the devices you have to use for input, and if you want a detailed video about it, please comment me. And let's switch up about output devices. So the output, very popular output devices are our CRT, and in undergraduate course you need to study in depth about CRT, basically what are the structure of it and how it works. Other output devices are LCD, liquid crystal display, LED is light emitting diode, and last is plasma panels. It will be popular after the CRT. It came after CRT, plasma panels, and after this LCD get popular, and currently LEDs are popular for use. And I'll just go through all the things later. First of all, I want to discuss about such thing. Now other concept, if we look at output devices, printer as well, because you are populating outputs through your printer. So printer is also part of output device. So there are so many types: laser printer, dot matrix printer, thermal and inkjet printer. So if we look at laser printers, we are using it widely. Through passing laser ray, we print what we need to. And dot matrix printer is your printer used in earlier days when we don't have a such laser concept. Using every pixel, every text as a dot, on its dot is generated. It's generated by the set of dots, so that's why it's called a dot matrix printer. Last is thermal printer, that is generated by heat, and next is inkjet printer, where it is plotted through the complete set. Whole set is displayed over there, and last about plotters, I will discuss it later. Let's talk about the CRT and how it's worked. Basically, this is the basic structure of CRT. These are the connector pins you see at the back of your monitor, and this is called as the base where we protect our all the inner structure through it. Then there is an electron gun. This is cathode, which generates the cathode rays. Basically, that's why CRT stands for cathode ray tube. And this gun, this ray is simulated throughout to plot over the screen. So using the focusing system, we focus whether this ray will go like upside, downside, or whether the path of the ray is decided. And further, we need to use horizontal and vertical reflection, because as I discussed in previous video, that we have a screen and X is going in this direction and Y is going in vertical direction. So we need to understand it, whether this ray will go. So all this information is already stored, and using the video controller, this deflection will work. Let's suppose this ray is going through this depict here. So this electron beam is pointed over the screen, and using a phosphorus coating, we see the screens. Basically, CRT display need a phosphor coating to display all the objects. A phosphorus property is that when a cathode ray strike a phosphorus screen, it will glow. Like in old TV monitors, you can see that when we turn off the TV, it's still glowing. Now the very last concept left about vector scan and random scan, that how our skin with screens will display. When we talk about vector scan or random scan, the object will be populated exactly where it is on the location. For example, we say direct access, like you know this object is there, so you just go and grab from it. Similarly, when we talk about random scan, you have the frame detail, you have the location detail, and this output is plotted over there. Now come my plotters. In case of plotters, we have a pen and sheet where we need to draw the object. So plotters, when we work on plotters, we feed the data and wherever the location, it just switch over the screen and the pen will plot where the object exactly need to be plotted. The next concept is raster scan display, which will be used in CRT. In case of CRT, we see that there is fluctuation. In all old system, there are some fluctuation. So the basically things will go like, they will glow the first line, then it will leave the next and glow the next. Like you can say that blue, if this is 1 and the green one is 2 and the blue one is again 3. So all the odd lines are glowed first, then the rays trace back and glow the rest of the lines. So in case of, you need just to draw this shape, the whole screen is need to be scanned. So these are the two basic concepts of random and raster scan, which we need to understand.